Hi there, Robin here from Expert On. Today we're going to be talking about the EON615 from JBL. Truly one of the nice speakers you're going to find in its price point when it comes to features, options, app capability, all of those type of things that really make a speaker today work really well. They were one of the first ones to kind of pioneer this whole thing when it came to actually interfacing this with our actual phone, so this way we can do some adjustments with it. There are speakers that cost more than the JBL EON615, and there are ones that cost less. We're going to talk about how this fits into that line of products today, and we're going to talk about the features in the back. What makes this speaker real important? Why does it sound so good? And why did so many people still buy it day after day? So first, we're going to be doing a sound check on it and taking a listen to it and see how it actually sounds. Then we're going to bring it over to the table and we're going to review all the features in the back and talk a bit more about the app options on it. So we'll see you in a second with the actual sound test. All right, so we've got the speaker set up and it's about 24 feet away from the camera. We've got it turned up to 75% on the back. We've got it set in main. And we've got the EQ on. I'm actually going to just hold down the EQ plus button. We'll show you that after the demo and turn that off. Now, again, that goes back to the app controls. We'll talk about that in a second. But for here, we're going to be doing that as a demo. So again, it's 75%. So I could have probably doubled that volume level or maybe tripled it, but I thought this proportionally would work good for the camera and for the actual video. Volume-wise, absolutely in its price point, fits in with pretty much everybody else. So a little bit louder, a little bit softer, but definitely more refined when it comes to a sound that you get. And again, we'll talk a bit more about that when we bring it over to the table, and that part's coming up next. All right, so here we are at the table. We've got the speaker. Now, JBL's got a great video on this. And they do talk about some real important parts, and you know, we're going to cover that, but we're also going to talk about some of the more detailed things that you don't normally hear one particular manufacturer talk about, and that's how it fits in the line of products as well. So we're definitely going to cover that. Now, just like I said, they black out the entire backside. A lot of the better companies do that as well. They blacked out their logo, and it's well attached. You can take it off, take a look, see. It looks just like the pictures. They've got a waveform guide around the actual woofer. Now, that's important because before we look at the back, we should cover how it makes a better sound than a lot of other speakers in that price range. Now, JBL spends a lot of time trying to figure things out. In this case, I think they got it right. The idea is that one of the small problems is that the horn is 60 by 90. So that's 45 degrees off on each side. Most woofers go right out there, so you know, you almost have double the output in range. So if we were to compare that with something, it's like saying, you know, I've got a cup of coffee and I poured my cream and sugar in it and I didn't stir the pot. So what happens is that, you know, you've got a lot of cream and sugar right down the middle and that's the sweet spot, but you're not getting anything on the outside. Or maybe think of baseball, the foul. Yes, you can hit the ball out there, but it's just not going to work for you. It's a foul. Another way of looking at it is in speaker terminologies, if we mix the highs and the lows and we get a good blend of sound, and that's right down the middle, that's going to come out at 45 degrees on each side, so 90-degree pour, coming out like that. Now, the problem is the woofer has this muddy spot on the outside, which doesn't have any highs or mids. It's just basically mid bass and bass coming out. So anybody who's out there on the fringes isn't really going to hear the same as everybody else. So that's really what they're talking about, is how to keep all of that mixed together really well. And that's why they have that funky thing going on around the actual woofer. So I hope that helps and explain why they did it. And, you know, it's not just a cool thing. It actually does something real important. Now, they go and go. Case made out of plastic, which it is, actually, funny enough. It's made out of kind of like some stuff they make football helmets out of, thereabouts. It makes it very durable. It makes it very rugged. And I'm going to add that into something I'm going to talk about when we look at the backside. Now, same thing. Handles, everything's designed in. It's all designed to be very comfortable, easy to use, easy to carry around. Bang it up, that's okay. That's what it's all about. Speakers like this do have, different models have it. This one has a good actual seat. When you use it as a monitor, the handles on the side lay down. We don't have a tiny little flange up. We don't have just a flat sit point. Rubber, like they talk about, is there. Grips, it sits really well when it's on the actual floor. When you get to the backside, we're going to notice a couple of things. This here, and on top, and I'll mention this as well, this speaker is about 2 inches taller than the average 15-inch speaker out there. When you lay it down, on top, we've got flywire connection, so we can hang it from the ceiling. And in the back, we have a third one. So, put that back up here. Now, handles, they say it has four. I confirm, there are four handles. One at the bottom, one at the top, left and right. Some of them only have three, some have two, some they don't allow you to set it up as a monitor on the left or on the right. It's only one-sided. This, your choice, you let it be the way you want it to be. On the back, here's the actual panel. So this is where the app comes into play. The unit's got some great features on it, but at any point, you need to pause this video, you can wait until it's done. It has a demo mode on it. So at Google Play, it's called the JBL EON Connect. So the JBL EON Connect. You want to download that. If this doesn't get you convinced how good the speaker is, this app, for sure. It has a demo mode on it, so you can play with all the functions, see how it works. You don't need a speaker for the app to work. You can see how all those functions are in there. Definitely well worth the download. And play around with that. It'll probably sell the speaker better than I can. So, on the back, this is what it's all about. When you get the app, you can do all kinds of things with it. Besides controlling the volume, you also have controls with bass and treble. They give you a really nice graph chart that you can play around with and do all that kind of stuff. But the important part is when you connect and you do those changes on the speaker, you don't need the phone connected afterwards. There's a button here that allows you to engage whatever your last setting was and disengage it. So this way, no worries. That's a neat feature they put there. Now, a lot of speakers have taken on this functionality right here, and that's to have a main, a monitor, a sub, and a speech. Now, that allows you to take the speaker around on its own, but also allows you to do things better and easier if, let's say you're a DJ, but somebody asks you to set up for just a service or someone's having a special event, but it's all speakers, right? So people are coming up, they're going to do their thing, and then they're going to move on. So you can make it so that that portion is going to sound better. So if you're only going out, you're doing a two-hour gig, and it's just so people can do some speeches, tweak the speaker, get it sounding better in speech mode. It really emphasizes the mid-range, cuts out the bass so you don't get the muddy, muddy bottom end. You don't have to play around with it all the time. So that's what's going on here. Now, there are two more buttons up on the top here, and that's for syncing and for booting up the unit. Now, because there is a computer processor inside of it, and it has a whole bunch of features that are being taken care of internally, when you power it up, it does take, I don't know, 5 to 10 seconds for it to get going. The unit will turn on, the light will start blinking, it'll do the own little cycle things, everything will flash on and off, and then the speaker will be ready to use. Now, here's one of my favorite parts about the JBL speaker, and this is what makes it really good for if you rent product, or maybe you're a guy looking to add DJs onto your services and you're going to be supplying them with equipment. Now, this is a really good speaker for that. Now, this is why. One, if you're renting it, a lot of speakers now incorporate the microphone and the line level in one knob. So that means somewhere around 12 o'clock, halfway up, it stops being a line input and turns into a mic input, which basically means you can easily overclock your speaker by 3 times the preamp input. and that's like supercharging your, you just can't run it like that all the time. Problem is your speaker, you know that, you're not going to abuse it. Now, problem is if you're putting out a speaker as a rental, worse, that's the worst case, or you have other DJs using your equipment, they may not know the level that the speaker should probably be set at, even though they said, I got you, they'll still turn it up too loud, and you have no control about it because you're not there. So this, the two actual line inputs, line one and line two, the in one and two, as they like to call it, has a hidden button that you use recessed. You have to literally have a pen, a paper clip. You have to have something with you to physically push that button in. That's the only way to turn it from a line input into a mic input. So no one's going to accidentally do that. So that means I can easily turn this up with confidence all the way, and I can take the volume, as long as I'm not overclocking on my mixer or controller, and turn that up all the way. So when I demo this speaker, I'm not, you know, paying attention how loud, make sure it's the right volume, don't have it too much, I don't want to overclock it. I don't have to worry about those things. That's what makes this speaker really good and makes it great for having it for other people or setting it up for a gymnasium where a lot of different people are interacting with it. Anywhere where you're not the only person touching the product, this makes the product very reliable, and then that adds to the longevity of the product. You're not going to blow the woofer, you're not going to blow the tweeter, you're not going to destroy the amp. Those things aren't going to happen because they did that one little simple thing and took the actual mic line inputs and put them as a recessor. I mean, you have to have something small, like a tiny screwdriver, or, you know, like I said, a paperclip. You have to get in here and physically turn that on. I can't do it with my finger. I can't. There's no way. That's not going to happen. So there you go. That's really what I like about this. Now, overall sound is awesome. I mean, again, because the design of the speaker was built making sure that the woofer lines up with the actual horn, that's going to make a big plus in sound quality. Can you buy louder? You can always buy louder because you can buy a machine that maybe has less on the back feature-wise, but they pour a little bit more into the overall power. So a good example is the new Alto TS-315, though more powerful, less features. So that's an important thing. You have to be more responsible with those type of speakers because you can easily overclock a speaker like that. They're a very good speaker. They're hundreds of dollars less than this speaker, but you have to be very responsible with that product. Now, I'm going to say a novelty feature to this. It's where it's made. Now, most speakers in this price point are made in China, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But somehow JBL, because they're on the West Coast and they wanted to keep everything close by, they actually have, I'm going to say, final assembly, so that makes it made in Mexico. So that's nice. It's, an opportunity to keep a factory in North America. So I'm going to say that's a good thing. So I just thought I'd mention that because I thought it was different. It was different. You can get that in real high price points, but not necessarily this range. So who uses this? DJs that DJ around 150 people, dance floors 32 by 32, that sort of size. It's always going to be, you know, if you're going to play a lot of dance music, that sort of stuff, you might want a subwoofer. And necessary, depends if you're doing school dances, weddings, maybe not necessarily. If you're doing high school, you know, anything big, then subwoofers are always a bonus. But that's completely different from everything else. Outside of that, you can run two, you can run four. The app handles up to four speakers. That's great. The 12-inch version, which we'll also do a review on soon, same power output. And we didn't talk about that because, I'll be honest, JBL is not even close to what other people talk about when it comes to wattage. Now, this one here is rated at 1,000 watts, but amazingly enough, that's peak. They don't tell you that it's 500 watts RMS, but at the same time, the dB level is 127 at 1 meter away, which is how they pretty much all do their tests now, which is stupid loud. And the sound quality, this is the closest thing you're going to get to a studio monitor, again, in this price range, for a speaker that's supposed to be stupid loud, which it is. Normally the rule is stupid loud is not stupid clean. And in this case, it pretty much is. I'd say they line up. It's probably one of the nicest sounding speakers at low volume levels, for under 750 US or under 1,000 Canadian. So anyways, we can talk all day about this. It is cool. It's amazing how it's one of the older models in our line of product, but probably most one of the most relevant for most people to compare to. So, you know, how's the Electro Voice compare to the JBL? How does the Mackie compare to the JBL? And it's because we kind of know what this is sounding like. We kind of grew up with the brand, and they're always really good pioneers at bringing out something new. When they do, they try and leapfrog and keep ahead of the game and have something for a few years. So when you buy this, you know it's going to take a while before there's such a dramatic change in the industry that you're going to go and say, God, I wish I bought a new set of speakers, you know, something different. Anyways, there you go. I think that's going to cover it all for today. Like I said, get the app, download it. It is really worth it. Again, it's the JBL EON Connect. It's a fun app to play with. It really makes you want to go down and pair it off to a speaker and see what it's all about. If you're looking for this speaker, looking for more details, we'll have all that down below in the links as well. So take time to subscribe. We've got always new products coming into the showroom. And if you liked the video, give us a thumbs up. Talk to you soon. Bye now.